All right, YouTube. Welcome back to the vlog. I am feeling so good, so rested. The body is bodying. The weight this morning is, 133.2, I think it was. And if you've been following Peak Week, you know I've been 136, 137 all week. Again, my fighting weight is 130, 131 on show day. Justin assures me I will be 131 tomorrow. He ain't never steered me wrong yet, so we shall see. I talked about how the way I look right now, this go round, the body is just maintaining and staying pretty full. So I didn't see a bunch of food. Now I got 20 extra carbs from a carb. So I would agree 100%. Like, I don't understand how and why, but it's maintaining, so I would accept. He said do nothing today. I asked him, could I get in the sauna? He said I could do 15 minutes if I wanted. So I'm thinking about going to LA Fitness and doing 15 minutes in the sauna and posing. I haven't decided yet, but I've already had one meal, and it was some egg whites, chicken, and rice and asparagus. Just kind of watching Netflix and chilling. I'm gonna just get up and start. I took an 800 milligram Motrin today, a prescription one, because I want to see with my meal. So if I do this tomorrow, because I'm gonna kind of try to pose all day today. So if I do this tomorrow, I want to see what it ends up feeling like tomorrow, my back and stuff. So I will keep y'all posted. But I'm not gonna spend too much time on here today because I ain't doing shit, number one, and I want the video to be mostly show day. But if I get into something, y'all know I would pick up the camera and bring y'all along. But I just uploaded a video that was basically Thursday and Friday. So 3 days and 2 days out. But anywho, I will see y'all soon. Okay, it's not the prettiest angle, but I'm just leaving the massage place. It was so good. It's one of these little local, what's it called, Cupid foot massage or something like that. The lady did an amazing job. I did a 60 minute body massage and a 30 minute foot massage. 90 minutes, perfect. I didn't have her go too deep or anything like that. We don't need no problems. This is exactly what the doctor ordered. Feeling a little drained. I don't get a lot of water today, so I'm feeling a little drained. So I'm gonna get my butt right on back. Justin said I could do 15 minutes in the sauna if I want to do the sauna, but I think I'm done in the streets for the day. I need to go and get my wig ready, and I want to kind of mess with my eye makeup a little bit because I have an idea of what I want to do and make sure that that's what I want to do. But so that's it for now. So real quick, so remember I told y'all about the girl that I met last night at check-ins? The figure girl, who this was her pro debut and she hadn't competed in 7 years, whatever. So I just checked the NPC news, and she made first call out in Masters. So let's go. She's 49, and she was thinking that, like, oh my god, I waited so long to make my pro debut, I'm too old for this. And first call out, looking like she's top three. Yes, bitch. So I just tried both my wigs on. I haven't decided which one I'm gonna wear, but I'm gonna wear the turquoise suit for sure, as long as the bottoms fit good in the morning. I needed some scissors to cut the curly one, and I'm like, shit, I don't have scissors. I forgot to put scissors in. So first of all, I'm glad I tried them on tonight. But then I went down to the front desk and they had some, so I was able to cut it down there. But I was like, oh my god, I am not getting in this car going anywhere. But probably gonna go with the more comfortable one tomorrow that probably won't hurt my head after being on for hours at a time. But we'll see. Not doing nothing, just laying around, feet up, watching Sex in the City, Seinfeld, all the things that's keeping it lighthearted, lightheaded. Just flat iron the one wig, the straight wig, and curled it or whatever, and then the other one is a curl pattern. So we'll see what I go with tomorrow, but I probably won't see y'all until tomorrow because there's nothing else going on. So I am wearing my 14 karat gold eye patches to work on the bags, I guess. I don't know if these things work, but hey, There's no harm in trying. And whitening the teeth. It's 256. I'll keep both of these on to about 3:30. And then I will go ahead and shower and shave and then tan before I send Justin the last check-ins at 5. I've already had all my carbs. Wasn't many. So we'll see. Right now my last meal is just some chicken with a whole egg, some egg whites to go with it, and asparagus. So we'll see. Spray bottle. I'm gonna do just one coat tonight and then one coat of the mousse in the morning. So one coat of the regular easy application bronzer liquid sun rays, and then they have a mousse, and I'm gonna do one coat of the mousse in the morning, and that's it. So right now I'm just waiting on Justin to reply. He wanted to know my weight right now, which is 134.8, and he wanted to know, what have I eaten so far? I only have one meal left, which would just be chicken, egg whites, and asparagus. So I'm waiting on him to tell me what he wants me to do. But in the meantime, in between time, I'm gonna go ahead and tan myself. So I will talk to y'all later. Morning, good people. It's show day. Eating my first meal, which is 3 ounces of rice. He wanted me to do 4. I didn't feel like doing all this. I ate one rice cake with this 3 ounces of rice because it was already measured, and chicken. I already sent my check-ins. I'll post them here. The weight did not come down. I'm 133.2. My fighting weight is 130 to 131. So we shall see. We'll see. Stay tuned. After I eat this, I'm gonna go through my makeup and stuff. And as I pull the whole look together, of course, I will show y'all. Good morning, people. Let's get this going. I'm about to start my makeup. So, full transparency. Not loving the weight. I asked Justin that I look heady. Do I just look like a heavy person this morning? I feel like I look okay. I feel like my glutes obviously could be tighter. They will be for the next show. But I just hope I don't look heavy. So we'll see. I mean, I guess it's relative in comparison to what I'm being compared to, but yeah, not loving it. So, we'll see what Justin says. Found a couple pictures that of eye makeups that I like. I didn't practice yesterday, I lost interest. So, there's that. All right. I have to get it going. Get my makeup out. Stay tuned. What I meant to say while I was on here was that I find doing my makeup to be so therapeutic. I love it. I really love it. Pre-dating starts at 9. I don't know if bikini's going first. I hope so. So I plan on leaving here at about 8:45, headed over. So we'll see. It's primer. Alright. Hopefully I look like something by the time y'all see this face here. Look at that. I was saying I didn't bring scissors and I did. I was going to say, it didn't sound like me not to bring scissors when I have wigs in the house, but I guess I would have found it out this morning. But either way, crisis averted. Well, this is where we are so far. Okay. This lighting's terrible. Got the hair up. So now I'm about to figure out which wig we're going to do. These lashes are struggling to hang on. I cannot put lashes on, but hey, the judges are far. So as long as I look cute from a distance, we good. All right, y'all. So I am headed over to the venue. It's kind of chilly. Looking a hot mess, of course. I don't know, y'all. I'm not really feeling the body. I feel heavy. And maybe because I know the scale. Had I not seen the scale, I probably would feel better, but I seen it. It's a 133.2. That is not my fighting weight. So I'm not feeling overly joyed about that. So we'll see. But this is the wig, this is the do, this is the look, this is the glam. I feel like the glam is good. I'm definitely glad I'm going with the turquoise suit, but I'm not feeling the body. Just being honest. But my Uber's on the way. And I'll be at the venue kicking it up here shortly. So I'm backstage. Me and Gina are noticing that there's, here's Gina. Say hey girl. This is for YouTube.
Hey.
She was one, remember I was complaining to y'all about the asses of the masters at Clash Pro? She was one of those asses.
I don't know why I just found some red hot, but
I advise against it, but here's backstage, and we're about to just start getting our lives together. Just left Cowbell Burgers. Had a turkey burger with sweet potato tots. It is 12:45. Finals start at 4 p.m. So I have just enough time to go back, get a little bit of a nap, and then go back. And then we're gonna hang something tough tonight. So. I hope this survey vlog is okay, y'all. It don't be nothing going on. I tried. I got a couple clips. And yeah. Just ain't much going on. Hopefully y'all can hear me. Anyway, let me focus. I see y'all back at the hotel. right, so I'm back in the room. I'm about to Netflix and chill, watch some Sex and the City. I have about 2 hours that I can actually nap, so I'm going to do that, and then head over back to finals. And then I'm just gonna catch an Uber. I don't think I'm gonna. Well, if I drive though, I could be in and out of there pretty quick. Maybe I'll drive. Anyway, yeah, I'm about to take a little nap. I had a turkey burger with some sweet potato tots, fat and full. Had about 12 ounces of water. Done eating and drinking until after finals. And so there's nothing more to report right now. Let's see. Let's talk about post-show feels. I don't really have any, you know, y'all know, if you're not new here, you know, I don't really get emotion behind the, like, I can objectively look at what I was being compared to. It was nine of us, and it was nine good girls. I think, like I said, when it comes to my glutes walking on and off, I think it hurts me. I think in my posing, in my routine, you know, the back is up, it's, you know, from that angle, it's not a side glute angle, you know, it can look the part. But then I lose that with the walk on and walk off. So, like, what are you gonna do? I need more tissue back there. I need more time. I think I did make some improvements in those 5 months, but there's just more improvements that just needs to be made, bottom line. I was off, like I said, my weight was up 3 pounds today. That's not my fighting weight. However, you know, even being 130, 131, would it have made a difference? Maybe. I probably still would have been top three in comparison to today, but maybe. I don't know. Tyler was the head judge. Mo was there. Joe was there. Who else was there? It doesn't matter. So yeah, very good show. Very well ran. You're literally in and out. Backstage is huge. You're not all on top of everybody. They're so organized. I think it's fair judging. Or at least it was from what I could tell. I did watch open. But yeah. Yeah, that's really it. Had a good time at just at lunch with Karen. So tonight, Gina's going to hang with us. And Karen. And I need to text Harriet to see if she's going to come out. And yeah, so saw my girl Celeste, which is always a plus, but I need to get my nap, so I will talk to y'all later. Okay. That nap was good. I don't feel like going back. This is too much. All right, let me get up and get moving. Hey guys, we are back here chilling. I kept doing that when Celeste would record. I'm like, delete, do it again. So we're back here chilling. It's supposed to start promptly at 4. Me and Karen, look, we are already plotting. People that's trying to go eat but thought they was gonna do two classes. Ain't nobody got time. Meet us at the restaurant.
See you later, Bob.
We're going to a place called Leroy Fox. I want to eat somewhere that I can't eat at home. So it's like Southern cuisine. So I'm excited. Keep y'all posted.
All right, y'all. So I am back from finals. We already went over how prejudging went, so I know I wasn't placing. Final thoughts. I knew I was going to be off when my weight wasn't doing what it needed to do. Like 3 pounds on my body, you can see 3 pounds. So it's just a matter of, will it be good enough that day? It's not my fighting weight, so it would be crazy for me to be like all riled up when I know I was off. Sometimes I could be off and do well. Sometimes I'm off and it goes how it should. Today it went how it should. I was off. So nothing to dwell on. We keep going. I have 2 more shows for the month. I am going to get back to the grind tomorrow. I land pretty early, so I will be doing around 2, and you know, the grind don't stop. We get right back on it and we do what we gotta do. So for right now, we're about to go eat at this place called Leroy Fox. The menu looks really yummy. Flying back first class, I will be enjoying. What else? Ooh, y'all, they had an Auntie Annie in the airport. Look at God. I will be partaking. It better be open when I come. through there. That's it. So I will bring the camera and we get into something fun or whatever tonight. I will definitely let y'all, this thing right here, oof. Oh, baby Jesus. Let that loose. Let the loose, honey. This head is sore from this wig. Oh. All right. Take these lashes off. I'm not going to take the makeup off yet just because I want to be ready when Karen gets here. She was the main one talking all this mess. We better be ready. We ain't not waiting on Gina. We're going to be ready to eat because she did Masters and Open. I told Gina, bitch, you got to meet us there because she be doing the most. Only for Karen tomorrow. So I can't leave without taking a picture with Sean in my coat. You do it too much. I'm going to go ahead and catch an Uber then. And I look, I might just be meeting you at the restaurant too. But she's going to come to my room and change, and then we're going to get out of here. I didn't bring any food, like snacks or anything like that, to have in my room. I don't like to do that because then I feel not pressured to eat it. But then I for sure eat what I probably wouldn't necessarily eat by stocking my room with that stuff. So I did not bring anything to stock my room with, you know, snacks and all that stuff. I've grown that. That's it, y'all. I don't think I'm gonna get overly cute because I just don't feel like it. We'll see what I throw on.
All right, y'all, just got to the restaurant. Waiting on Karen. I need to figure out what this parking situation is. Oh, it's a homemade ice cream place right there too. Yeah, I'm super hungry, super thirsty, super excited. So let me figure out this parking situation. And then, what kind of food? Oh, Latin Street Grill. Yeah, so we're here. Maybe I'll show y'all a table. I really don't like doing that. I hate when people just kind of like show all this crazy food and stuff they're eating. Not that I'm going to be eating something so crazy, but like post show, and that's all people like to like show and show themselves eating and just all the foolishness. It just really irks my soul. So I don't know if I'm going to do all that, but we'll see. Guys, it is 9 p.m. I am done with dinner. Now about to shower off all this tan, all this makeup, and get my butt in bed. My flight doesn't leave till 11, so I can sleep in a little bit and finish packing in the morning. So I will see y'all tomorrow. Morning time. Wow. So, your girl is up. She's moving. I'm probably going to leave here at like 9, headed to the airport. It's almost 6 o'clock. I'm going to run downstairs and see what they have for breakfast. I'm definitely going to eat whatever they have on a plane, so I'm not trying to do too much downstairs. I also have half of this black bean wrap that I got last night. So whatever they have down there is too much going on. I might just have this because I would like to save a bulk of what I'm gonna eat today for on the plane. So I'm only doing one gym session today. I'm not gonna go this morning. My body's really sore and tender from the water depletion and the diuretics. So I'm not gonna push it. I'm just gonna drink up and just go to the gym. So basically when I land, I took an Uber. So I landed 1 something, but I probably won't get home till like 2:30. I'm gonna go straight to the gym, probably just do an hour cardio, and then hit the grocery store on the way home, and then call it a night. And then the grind starts all over. Y'all, listen, after prejudging of any show, no matter how well I did or how bad I did, I'm over it. Like, this moment has come and gone. Let's move on to the next. So on to the next. The grind continues. We still got work to do. I can get leaner. And that's what she gonna do. And she gonna love doing it. So yeah, I will probably see y'all at the airport. Thank you.
cardio. Just got in, as you saw. I'm gonna go do probably an hour of cardio and then hit the store, cause your girl gotta get some food to and yes, the Grime Juice Strong. So it's funny how there could be such a sense of emptiness after prep if you don't have a plan of like what you're doing next. It's just like this big buildup, this big high. And then it's like you're so lost. Like, you know, after the show, you're fine. You're so happy to go eat and hang. And the next day you wake up and you're like, now what? What am I, what, like, like, if you love prep like I do, this is like, now what am I doing myself? So it's good to like kind of have a plan in motion. However, the plan may change ahead. But what I do know today, right now, the grind don't stop. So I'm headed over to Lifetime and then I'm gonna go to the grocery store. So I'll do a quick grocery haul after that, and then probably gonna close the video out from there. In the morning, so I've been eating. I had, after the show, after the morning show, I did the turkey burger with sweet potato tots. And then that night we went to Leroy Fox, and I had the fried cauliflower and a black bean wrap. And the black bean wrap came with sweet potato tots. And I had a side salad. And then this, someone ordered the buffalo chicken dip. So we all shared that at the table. And I coke for my drinks. And then I ate, I got some Auntie Annie's pretzel bites, the originals. And then I had a Kind bar. I ate the first class meal, which y'all saw. Pretty much all I had today, but that's 2 days of fucking around. Such a small window before it like really affects you. So we're just gonna get right back to it. Like I'm done, go to the store, get my shit, I'm done. I need to get back on my meal plan and get my life together. So that's what I'm about to do. Good people, the grind continues. I'm at the gym. I'm gonna do probably just an hour, but I am gonna pick up these 90 minutes for the rest of this week just to kind of get my shit together, and then we'll assess from there. But yeah, man, that is truly it. Ain't nothing to talk about, just do it. All right, good people. So I'm going to go ahead and close the video out here. This is my second attempt with this because this lady just got in a sauna, wore me the fuck out. The mouth noises, to situate herself on the bench, the smack in the gum, like, oh my God, please die. I hate you so much. I couldn't deal, so I had to get out of the sauna. I could not get a sweat going at all. I have on, excuse me. I have on Fit Gel and hemorrhoid cream. Did not break a sweat during cardio 50 minutes later. So I wanted to get in the sauna to try to break a sweat. But then she got in and the devil was busy. Anyway, so I had to stop recording in there. So I'm going to close the video out here. So here's where I'm at with everything. And please bear in mind, some of y'all that know me will believe me. Some of y'all would think it's based off of the placings. It's not based off the placings. It's based off of the results of the physique I brought and the process to get there. So
I have my flight to do Wasatch, and I want to do Emerald at the end of the month, the 27th. But as I'm looking at my video, which is the same issue I had looking at my video from last year, which made me take the 5 months off. So I feel like I made some improvements, but my glutes from the back don't bother me. Like they, if I'm in shape, like not holding them extra 3 pounds, like they can hang. But from the side, the walk up and the walk out, like that shit matters. It's not quite like a pancake flat, but maybe like a little English muffin. Like it's a little bump, but it's a disaster though. And again, that shit matters. Like this is the pro stage. This ain't, you know, whatever. So it matters. And so I need to get that together. I'm never going to have huge projection glutes because my glutes don't wrap around. Like my muscles aren't formed like that. So that's not what I'm looking for and trying to fix. I'm trying to get back to the Shantae 4 years ago. Like that side glute. And so I just need more tissue. So with that being said, obviously that takes time. But at the same time, I'm not ready to end prep. Like I'm loving this process. And in my mind, I was prepping through the month of April. So I'm not ready to call it quits. I need a few days to think about what I want to do before I talk to Justin. But also, I've been very transparent about throughout this whole process. I really was not connected to the prep. And I don't know if it was the prep or the idea of doing the show. I'm not sure which one it was. Because now that I think about it, I don't want to end prep. Like, I'm loving YouTube. I'm loving the work. I don't mind the work. I'm not working now, so I have the time. So, it makes me sad to think that prep is over. However, I'm not blind. I know what the look is, and I know I don't have it. So what sense does it make? So, and again, like I said, I've been struggling throughout this whole prep, and I said I was not competing. If y'all have been following this series, I said I was not competing for the right reason. It was out of fear of having regrets. Because I've got to have a hysterectomy too. And I don't know if that's going to take me out the game altogether. If that's going to make me be out the game for a year or two. So I just felt like if I didn't do this, I would regret it. So I don't regret doing the show. I'm glad I did the show. Now, I do not love that the body decided during peak week, it don't want to do it no more. It was tired. It didn't want to do it no more. I've never had to cardio this hard on this little macros. I haven't had a break since 2020. Okay. I've never... never, ever, 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 ever in all my 52 shows have I ever not dropped during peak week. Never has that ever happened to me. So I don't know if my body like, bitch, get it together. So I don't know if my body needs a break, but like as I took y'all on this journey, and I'm glad I did during peak week saying, you know, on Monday or Tuesday, like I'm not worried today because I don't have to be ready today. I have to be ready on Sunday. But I wasn't worried, but I was damn sure pissed the fuck off when we competed Sunday. So Saturday, the scale was still 133. Oh, I was pissed the fuck off. But Justin's like, you know, he was nervous to do too much because we've done that and it was a disaster. And so we played it safe and I didn't drop. I don't think it shouldn't have even come to that. So it's not a Justin thing or whatever. It's not a Shantae thing. I did all the things. We did all the things. The body just did what it, the fuck it wanted to do. And so I'm like, is it time for a break? Is it? But I'm not ready to stop. Like, I love the process. I love the grind. I like the accountability. I like the strict schedule. I like the routine. You know, I'm not hungry, you know, so I'm like, I don't know, y'all. Like, so, okay, so there's that. So then also, now what's really in the back of my mind is me and Daddy was trying to go see our parents before we left the country. So he decided not to do the last show, Emerald, on the 27th because he's like, when you go do that, I'll just go see my mom in Indiana and then we'll leave the country after that. Then I'm like, so when do I get to go see my mom? And so I was choosing to compete versus take my ass to Houston. So now I'm like, do I skip Wasatch, do Emerald, and use that time to do it, you know, pull up on Houston? Oh, I don't know. But here's what I do know today, in this moment while I'm making this video and closing it out. I'm not ready to stop the prep grind. I'm not. I'm 100% not. So as of today,
I'm not. I'm still in prep. And as of tomorrow, I'm going to do a check-in video to collect the data from all my foolishness for the last 2 days. This morning I was 138. Tomorrow I'll probably be that or more because of the flying. I did not break not one sweat, so the amount of water retention is not going to be cute. I can only imagine what the pictures going to look like or the video, but I'll put it. We're going to start the next video out with that because as of today, I'm still in prep. I don't know. But all I do know is that the plan has always been after April to take a break because I have to get the hysterectomy, which was going to be, I was pretty much going to be done for the season anyway. So I foresaw that coming. But I'm like, do I spend all this money doing these next two shows knowing that my biggest issue is not going to be resolved by then? I got to get that side profile together. Like I said, I can... If I come in tighter, like my 130 fighting weight, I can pose my way around the dumb shit. But that walk on, walk off, I can't be carried off. I got to get off stage. So it's problematic, y'all. Like, so a few people messaged me. It's like, did you get feedback? No, Jesus. I think it's clear. Like, I don't have time to do all that. When fix the obvious and then we can talk. Like, it's very clear it was some foolishness going on. So I'm very proud of myself. I'm very proud of myself for sticking through this prep. I did the best I could with what I had. I definitely should have cut the gum. That stuff was not going to matter though. Then peak week, the body just didn't want to do it. Didn't want to do it anymore. I don't know why. That has never happened to me before. And like, you know, me and Fatima was talking. She was like, sometimes it just happens. Me and Kimber was talking, and she was saying how, you know, she was feeling a little bummed because she took all that time off to put on muscle. And then as she's dieting for her show, the Florida show, she's smaller than she competed last year. So she was like, was it all for nothing? Like, let me get on my head. And then for this show, she was up from the last show. So she's like, so it's just, we all go through it. Like, this is not a special case scenario. So it just is what it is. I just need to figure out what I'm going to do. So y'all just keep rocking with your girl. We're going to figure it out. But as of today, she is still in prep. She will be up at 145 tomorrow getting the shit done. We're going to take some check-in videos tomorrow and see what's what. But for now, thank you guys so much for rocking with me. I hope this show vlog was okay. Feel free to leave me comments and stuff. It's very hard to, like, especially when I was pissed off with the weight not coming off. I just was pissed off about it. Me 3 pounds up is me 3 pounds up, and it shows. Like, it's nothing. It shows. So I did the best I could with recording. So, I mean, be kind, but if y'all want to give some constructive feedback, fine. I'll receive it. But, I did the best I could as far as the mental space I was in. But other than that, I'm so glad I did the show. I had the best time. It was the best day, the best travel to and from, like, no fucking issue. The whole, everything was on point. I had the best time with Karen and then her two friends. It was two separate friends, but they went with us for lunch and then went with us for the dinner. And just the conversation, it wasn't about competing. It was one of the girls, a 911 operator. And so it was like real life stuff. And it was just so nice to just like hang with grown folk and just, you know, socialize and just catch up with Karen and, you know, see what my girl been up to, because I haven't seen her in person since 2022 when I did Charlotte. So it was a time had. So I'm going to go do my grocery shopping and stuff. I'm going to do check-ins in the morning. Next vlog will start with that. So, again, I appreciate you more than you know. Thank you guys for all your support, all your encouragement. And we're just going to let the chips fall where they may. But as of today, your girl is still in prep. So, the work must go on. And I will see y'all in the next episode. Let's do a quick grocery haul before we end this vlog. Staple rice cakes. Got some Quest chips to do my little nachos. Chicken, romaine lettuce, spinach, cucumbers, vegan cheese, the Follow Your Heart brand, love that one the best, tomatoes, yellow potatoes, 96% ground beef. I already have green beans. We got rice. Yeah, that's it.
Oh yeah. So remember when, first of all, I did a whole closeout and then now here I am still talking. I wanted to show y'all the little small grocery haul that I did for the week. And but remember, if you've been following the series, I was saying maybe two episodes ago, because it was after the clash, and I was saying like, oh Lord, did I do enough? Hell no. To the no, 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 hell to the no. No, I did not do enough. I need to keep working. But so yeah, there's that. But I just wanted to come on here to say that. And I know I did a closeout and then I had a few clips after that. So now for real, your girl about to go to bed. Moisturize this with hair. Moisturize this face. And then get in my bed, relax, and watch my recorded shows and get this week going. Because we got a lot of beef left to do. Let me recap all the things I ate, because I think I just told y'all. I remembered, you know, the little Biscoff, two-pack Biscoff cookies that come on the plane? Yeah, I had him get me three of those packs. I thought he was going to give me two. He got me three. So I ate six of those cookies. The meal I had, well, y'all saw it. And then he brought a basket of snacks around, so I got a bag, like a bag of this pistachios, honey roasted pistachios, and a Kind bar out of that. What else? Oh, one of those little small little containers of like ice cream. That was dessert. So Haagen-Dazs ice cream, had that. Told you about the Auntie Annie. I think that was it. Your girl been grubbing today. So end of day weight right now, 144. Yesterday, end of day was 138. 139, then this morning I woke up at 138. I didn't use the bathroom this morning either. So I took that Dr. Bio, whatever that supplement I showed y'all, I got from Amazon. So I just took that. So hopefully I'll go in the morning. So yeah, my stomach is like so hard from probably not going to the bathroom, eating all the bullshit I ate yesterday, on top of all the bullshit I ate today. So yeah, hopefully I go in the bathroom in the morning. So, but I'm gonna do some check-in video. Listen, sis did what she did, so I'm gonna have to pay the piper. All right, not for real this time. Thank y'all so much for watching, and I will see y'all in the next video.